Welding is a process of joining together two pieces of metal. There are many methods of welding. Electric arc welding is one such method, and it is used to join steel sheets, bars, or shaped materials like angles. Manufacturing industries like automobile and ancillary units, pipe fabricators, structural fabricators, and construction industry use arc welding to the maximum. The technique of arc welding depends on the correct usage of material and precise processes to be followed. The skill and art of arc welding is a skill that has to be mastered with concentrated effort and training. The welder has to understand the following:
type of electricity applied, type of electrodes used, type of tools used, and the safety precautions to be taken. Welding equipments can be classified as transformer, which is a source of electrical energy, cables and clamps, which earth and hold electrodes, and electrode that melts and fuses the metal parts together. The tools necessary for welding are slag pick hammer, hammer and center punch, steel scale, tape, and angle protractor.
It is very, very important for a welder to use good safety practices, keeps his tool handy, use safety precautions, and keeps his surroundings clean and tidy.
The most important safety equipments are apron, goggles, hand gloves, and face shield. Arc welding process depends on electric current, and so the cables and connections have to be properly insulated, safe for handling to avoid electric shock. There are some basic principles of arc welding. Electric arc is formed when two terminals of an electric circuit are brought together and quickly separated by a gap. High current passes through this air gap. The spark results in intense heat. This heat melts the metal fast and helps in joining with the other. In arc welding, the job is kept at one polarity by clamping the earth cable of the transformer directly on the job or on the metallic work table. The electrode and the holder form the other polarity through a cable connected to variable transformer. The transformer in turn is connected to the main switchboard. Creating an arc is called striking an arc, which is similar to striking a matchstick. The electrode, after contacting and breaking away, causes an arc. Once the arc is created, the electrode should be moved uniformly by good hand control. The welder should always keep the electrode tip at the required height, as long, medium, or short. Short arc is used generally for getting good root penetration and while using heavy electrodes. Medium arc is used while welding MS plates, using mediums, coated electrodes for a final cover run. Long arc is generally used to restart an arc at the end of bead or while filling a crater.
You may ask, what is polarity in DC arc welding? Polarity indicates the direction of the current flow in the welding circuit. On DC or direct current, current flows from the positive to the negative terminal. The advantages are suitable for ferrous and non-ferrous metal, bare wire electrodes can be used, it can be used with generators, polarity changes are possible, arc production is easier. The disadvantages are high initial cost, high operating cost, high cost of maintenance, low work efficiency, noisy, and occupies more space. In alternative or AC, current changes polarities frequently. The advantages are low initial cost, low operation cost, low maintenance cost, higher efficiency, noiseless. Disadvantages are bare electrodes cannot be used, welding thin gauge sheets are difficult, It can only be used where main power is available. In both AC and DC method, the job has to be clamped very securely to the earth clamp and the cable to the transformer.
There are many types of basic welded joints. They are butt joint, corner joint, edge joint, lap joint, and T joint. There are also two types of welds, groove weld or butt weld, and fillet weld. The requirements of a good butt and fillet weld are root gap, which is the distance between the parts to be joined. Leg length is the distance between the junction of the metals and the point where the weld metal touches the base metal, called toe. The material or the part to be welded is called parent metal. The depth of fusion zone in the parent metal is called fusion penetration. The parts to be joined nearest together are called roots. The surface formed by squaring off the root edge of the fusion face to avoid a sharp edge is called root face. The first run deposited in the root of a joint is called root run. Root penetration is the projection of the root run at the bottom of the joint. The metal deposited during one pass is called a run. A small weld deposited on the root side of a butt or corner joint is called sealing run. Backing run is a small weld deposited on the root side of the butt or corner joint. Throat thickness is the distance between the junction of the metals and the midpoint on the line joining the two toes. The point where the weld face joins the parent metal is called toe weld. The surface of a weld, seen from the side from which the weld is made, is called weld face. The boundary between the fusion zone and the heat affected zone is called weld junction. The portion of a surface which is to be fused on making the weld is called fusion face. The depth to which the parent metal has been fused is called fusion zone.
Now, you've learned the basics of welding. Next, we need to prepare the joints. Why do we need to prepare the joints? The joints need to be prepared so that we can achieve a certain strength of the joints. As you're aware, arc welding is a process of depositing molten metal on two joints. It is imperative that the joints be free of jagged edges, oil, paint, and other impurities. Sometimes, beveling of edges may also be needed for a V, a double V, or a J form.
There are some methods for edge preparation. The joining edges may be prepared for welding by any one of the methods: flame cutting, machine tool cutting, machine or hand grinding, and filing or chipping. Different types of edge preparations generally used in arc welding are single V butt, single U butt, single bevel butt, single J butt, double bevel butt, double J butt, corner fillet, single bevel fillet, T fillet, double bevel fillet, and lap fillet. The position of the welding joint line and the weld face with reference to the ground axis indicates the welding position. The basic welding positions are flat or downhand position is the normal horizontal position of welding. Horizontal position is a technique of welding where the line to be welded is kept parallel to the welder. In vertical welding, two techniques are available for up and down welding. The up technique is used for heavy sections and large fillets where root penetration is very important. The down technique is usually restricted to lighter sections and joints where penetration is not a problem. Overhead position is usually done in site welding for building construction and structural columns, sometimes with vertical and horizontal construction. For producing a good weld, a proper electrode has to be used. Electrode is basically a wire of standard length and gauge and generally covered with a flux. The ratio between a wire and a coating is known as coating factor. On arcing, the electrode melts and deposits on the surface being welded. 1.25 to 1.3 light-coated electrodes, 1.4 to 1.5 medium-coated electrodes, 1.6 and above heavy-coated electrodes. There are many types of flux coating of electrodes. They are cellulosic, rutile, basic or hydrogen controlled, iron powder electrodes, composition or characteristics flux, and some other fluxes. There are many types of electrodes. They are mild steel electrodes, deep penetration electrodes, contact electrodes, cutting and gouging electrodes, underwater welding electrodes. Electrodes should be kept in a dry place, as moisture-affected electrodes cause cracks, porosity, and rusting. The electrodes should be stored away from wet surfaces and atmospheric dampness with silica gel in a container. Moisture-affected electrodes should be dried in a drying oven at 110 degrees to 150 degrees centigrade for 1 hour before use. During welding, with the heat of the arc, the electrode coating melts and it stabilizes the arc, forms a gaseous shield around the arc which protects contamination and compensates the losses of basic element.